Yeah, for the round two, I guess. The leagues don't really have set in stone rounds because it could be round two for me, but round, three or four for him. So, second round for the video, though. Aside on leagues, I absolutely love them. They've been great. Just being able to sit down, play a league in, 2 hours. You play more matches and it's shorter, time-wise than a daily event. It's great. And if you can only play one or two matches and, have to go to, want to go to sleep or something or, do anything else, you can do that. It's just so they're so awesome. I'm very, very happy with them. But anyways, back to the match. His hand is solid. Again, no Elvish Mystic, so that's unfortunate, but we got some two drops and a rally and a siege rhino. So we're playing against another control deck, blue black this time. I think the matchup plays out pretty similarly. A little definitely worse because they have stuff like Thoughtseize, so they can actually fight rally on a different axis than counterspells, which I think we're pretty well set up against counterspells because we have our own Thoughtseizes and pressure and stuff, but anyway, so I think I don't want to crack this because I would like to draw a land here. Great. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and just jam a Satyr here. Hopefully, I draw an elf to cast next turn because I'm certainly gonna cast this Divine Ends Elite if I don't have anything else to do. I would like to do something else. Okay, well, that was a very bad. Well, I mean, obviously we didn't hit a land, so it wasn't good, but I did put two cards that are good to have in my graveyard in my graveyard, so a visionary and a shaman. I'd really love to draw a visionary here, or an Elvish Mystic. I guess maybe another Wayfinder. Visionary, perfect. See, I guess it looks like my plan this game is just to set up this rally. I mean, that's usually your plan against control. And hopefully I can pressure him a bit, make him do something, and then just rally to kill him. So if I just jam, I think I'm going to, because if I just jam or whatever, and if he plays Languish, then I can untap and play Siege Rhino, which is guaranteed to resolve. Then he needs to, like, downfall it or something. So if he has, like, Languish and downfall, I guess I fall a little bit behind, but I do have Absent Charm to draw some cards. Maybe I could just Absent Charm. This isn't much pressure though, so I think I want to play at least Divine Ends Elite. Maybe I don't play Mystic here, but I don't really have a good spot to play Mystic the next turn either. Because if I don't draw a land, I'm gonna play Siege Rhino, so I'm just gonna go ahead and jam. It's also, he might just not have a Languish, so I'm gonna play this first. I don't think there's any way he counterspells it, but you never know. Whereas he might, he'll be, probably if he doesn't have Languish, he'll probably counterspell this Divine Ends Elite. Well, he probably just has Languish. I mean, if he languishes and I draw a land, I could also just rally. I would draw two cards, find a land, get a 1/1, and drain him for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's not the worst. It doesn't, like, put any. It doesn't, like, continue to pressure him though. I'm pretty sure I'm just gonna jam Rhino no matter what happens here. I really want to save this rally to be like backbreaking. I mean, again though, like I said before, he can actually fight. I can't just sandbag rally forever because they could have Thoughtseize. That's a pretty good draw. So now even if he has Rhino for or downfall for Rhino, or removal spell for Rhino, I can still just jam both of these. So he does. Okay, so I'm just gonna play both of these guys. I can also draw two cards and play Elvish Mystic. But no, I think I just want to put pressure. I really want to get him to, like nine or something. Nine is a life total that Rally can easily be lethal for. Like right now, it's doing what? Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. So now, actually, a Rally right now for four would deal nine damage. Or no, I didn't count any of these guys, too. So actually, it would deal 12. So actually, I only need to hit him once to make a Rally lethal. So technically, if I drew a land, I could try to kill him next turn. There's just no possible way I would because, you know, I have the upper hand with all this pressure, and he has open mana. I might as well. I don't know about upper hand, but you know, I'm like forcing him to react. So I'll definitely save it, but we'll see. If he like, if he taps out for, he doesn't tap out. If he casts Perilous Vault, he has two mana up, which unfortunately is enough to. Clash of Wills. Oh, Silumgar. Okay, so. Oh, I can't attack through that, so. Let's see. So, three. So, one, two, three. Oh, I can attack. Oh, yeah, no. Oh, but I have to. I can't attack with my elf because I have to tap it for mana. So, I can attack with these two. He blocks Dwight Inslee, takes one, but then that generates an extra elf when it comes into play. So, I'll have two elves in play. Two, three, four. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So I can put him to 1. I can put him to 1, but then he can attack with Silumgar and kill all my Elvish Warriors. I do get to draw. I do get to draw two cards. So if I hit a Cord, I can kill him. I think I'm going to go for it. Also, just putting him to 1 if I draw any Shaman is lethal. If I attack with my Visionary, then I can't get Seedrunner back, so that's obviously not great. Okay. Oh, not that. So I think I have to draw a Cord here. But, I mean, he tapped out for Silumgar, so it's possible his hand doesn't have counterspells in it. Then again, he also, like, if he has counterspells, he thought, you know, it was safe to tap out here. So he could tap out, get the Silumgar in play. And then if he untaps with Silumgar and counterspells, he basically can't lose. So I guess that's not true. He could easily still have counterspells. Hopefully I just counter drawing and it's lethal. I don't think so, though. Another rhino in our graveyard. Okay, I didn't draw a Cord. Oh, it was lethal. So I did miscount. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Huh. I must have missed one of the elves in my graveyard. Oh, well, that makes things way easier. Again, lucky we won game one, because I think game two gets the map makes the matchup actually pretty good. So there's not much that he can really bring in, you know, maybe like an extra like some Drowning Sorrows, but I guess Drowning Sorrows pretty good. So okay, there's stuff he can bring in, but I think our stuff is way better. You know, Den Protector and Thoughtseize are just backbreaking in this matchup. I'm gonna board pretty much the same way. Reclamation Sage, actually, if I'm cutting down on Cords, though, it's a lot harder to justify having it in the deck. Because it does against Perilous Vault, and usually they only play, like, one Perilous Vault, so I don't think so. I don't think I'm going to bring it in, or leave it in, but there is a little bit of merit to it. Get these out of here. Yeah, I don't think I want a Reclamation Sage. I'm still considering, because if he does ever like tap out for Perilous Vault and I Rex Sage it, it's a huge blowout, you know. But if he only has one Perilous Vault in my deck and I only have one Reclamation Sage and one Cord in my deck, the chance of that coming up is actually very slim. Of course, after I say that, I'm sure it'll come up this game where he plays Vault and I just have Cord in hand. His hand is a little awkward because I don't really have fast creatures to kind of get under his counter spells, but I do have double rally and a satyr, so I have some power if I draw some cheap stuff. I think I'm gonna keep. I also have seed rhino, which can do a lot of work on its own. Granted, it's not likely to resolve or live, so there's that, but yeah, that was a good draw. I'm going to fetch. I think it's likely that we, by the time we need, you know, four and five lands, we're going to have it, especially with this Visionary and Wayfinder, so I'd rather just draw a spell. Go Forest. Now, I could play that and then play Rhino next turn. I'm going to do that. My decision would have been a lot easier if you played an untapped land, because then I can, you know, just jam Rhino, and I can't really play around Dispel it. But I mean, I guess it's the same thing. I can't really play around Dissolve anyways, because next turn he'll have three up. But I mean, the fact that he plays an untapped land, so like, obviously it's very possible that that's all he had. But if he has, say, like, untapped land, Dissolve, tap land, he's very likely to just play the untapped land here. So if he has tap land clash, untapped land dissolve, then I guess it doesn't matter, because I'm getting counterspelled either way. But like, I feel like him playing temple means it's just slightly less likely he has dissolve, just because there's more combinations where he would play temple, there where he would not play temple if he had dissolve. But I still think I have to just jam, though. I'm going to crack this again. Just same reasoning as before. And hopefully I can use the Satyr to find a... I'm casting Seed Runner anyway, so now. But and then I can hopefully find... But I'm not going to cast Rally anytime soon, so I'll be able to hopefully draw some lands. So now I can play this. Now I can play this around Clash, but then it just gets like downfalled before I can flip it. So I'm going to go ahead and jam Rhino. Also, if I jam Rhino... he doesn't have clash, then if he has to downfall it, then I can... Okay, so he didn't have clash, so that was lucky. If I draw a land now, I can like morph down protector and flip, get back Rhino. Ashiok, okay, well that's just gonna instantly die. I don't think I'm going to play Dam Protector if I draw a land, because if he has a Wrath, I don't really have anything good to get back, even though I can play and flip. Actually, I'm going to attack Ashok anyways with Eldritch Mystic, so I can't play and flip. But this works out well, because I can cast my other stuff. I'm pretty sure I'm going to cast them both, because if he taps out for Wrath, I can, assuming I hit a land, I guess I'll cast this Wayfinder first, and if I hit an untapped land, I'm definitely going to cast Visionary. If I hit a tap land, I might just play that. Okay, sweet. Because now if he taps out for Crux, I can just play a I can morph a Dem Protector and then flip it. That's a decent draw. He didn't even have Crux, so... I mean, he... Okay, jeez, that's a lot of rallies. So he doesn't have to quite do something yet. Like, he could just, you know, cast, like, Jace's Ingenuity here or something. Like, when I attack, he's not guaranteed... He doesn't really have to stop this, you know. He's still at 19. But I don't think he can take two hits. So he's going to cast something anyway. So Downfall... I guess Downfall is a reason maybe not to attack with Mystic, because now if I cast Dem Protector face down and he clashes, I can't flip. But it's very... I mean, he didn't have clash last turn, or two turns ago. So it's unlikely he has clash now. I think playing Shaman might just actually be better, though. I play Shaman. he goes to 13. And then if I attack him for 6, he goes to 7, which is pretty dangerous. So he basically like has to wrath, or I mean, he obviously doesn't have wrath because he used downfall. So if he doesn't have wrath, that means his hand consists of like more lands and digs possibly, or dissolves. He hasn't really. I mean, he played Ashiok that turn. He played Ashiok instead of leaving up Dissolve, which Ashiok did absolutely nothing. You know, it was just immediately going to die. So I don't think there's any way he had a counterspell when he played Ashiok. So I don't think he has any counterspells in hand. I mean, he has one unknown in hand, so I'm mostly talking about the three cards in his hand. But I don't think they can really be a counterspell. They certainly can't be a Wrath. I guess maybe they could be a Wrath if the other card he drew was a Clash of Wills. Because then he wanted to leave up Clash for a Rally for 4. But Rally for 4 wouldn't even have been good there. So I don't think... I think there's no way he can have a Wrath in hand. Three of his cards can't be a counterspell, so that means they have to be a combination of, like, maybe... Like, it could be Ugin, another Ashiok, lands. So there's cards that I don't care about. If it's Perilous Vault, I think he just dies. So he plays Perilous Vault, so if I play Shaman... He goes to 13, he plays Perilous Vault, I attack, put him to 6, and then I can't actually rally, so I don't have double white. I guess I didn't think about that. I guess I could play Den Protector, and then if he like taps out for Vault, I could flip it up and return Windswept Heath. I think I like just jamming this Shaman. Yep. This also plays a little bit better against Clash. But like I said, there's no way he can have Clash into Wrath with the cards in his hand. He would have to draw the Wrath. I think it's impossible for him to have a Wrath. Unless his Wrath is... Okay, so yeah, I was about to say, unless his Wrath is Languish or... I didn't think about that, because that wouldn't have killed Rhino. So that makes sense. But I can just... Now if I just draw a Plains, I assume he's dead. 13? I guess he did have a land, but... Again, I just don't think he has a Clash on hand. Let's see. If I draw a White Source, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, it's only 9. And that's a pretty good draw for, like, next turn. I'm certainly not going to tap mana with this Stem Protector in play. Also, if he did have Clash for 1, I would then Thoughtseize him just to make sure he does, you know, to try to prevent this from dying. I'm not sure exactly what I'm going to rebuy here. I might just rebuy Windswept Heath still, honestly. So then I can attack him for 3. And how much did this rally do? Did I decide? 1, 2, 3. 3, 4, 5, 6. So the rally only does 9. I can't actually go Thoughtseize rally, but I think I'm going to return Plains and then rally on his end step, which deals him 9 and draws me a card, and then still have more rallies. You know, if he counters it, I can untap and rally. So yeah, I'm going to do that. Okay, so that may mean that a rally is just lethal. So I'll get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, I'll have 6 creatures post rally, so I can cord for 3. So if he, say he like taps out for dig, end of turn, I can rally in response and kill him. I mean, with me, like, flipping this and getting back Windswept Heath, it's super obvious that I have Rally in hand, I think. So it's unlikely he just taps out, but... I mean, to be fair, though, I guess maybe not, because a Rally's not actually lethal. A Rally only puts him to 1. Jeez, Ingenuity. I think I'm going to just respond to this, because... Again, I still don't think he has Clash, unless he drew it, you know, the last turn. Or no, I can only rally for 3. Hold on. So I don't actually get my rhinos back. Or no, I know, I can rally for four. Yeah. Never mind. Between court and rally, it's hard to keep track of what costs 2x and what costs 3x. Okay, he just f6, so he's dead. I guess, yeah, I can even cord for the other shaman before the first shaman resolves to get an extra point there. It's not that it matters, but, oh wait, is he just dead to this? Did I somehow do that? No, I only have three elves, right? One, two, three elves, yeah. I was gonna say, did I do the math again wrong again? Yep. All right, so... Yeah, the control matchups seem great. You know, you have a clock that they have to answer, and then you have a rally, which, assuming things are going okay, is almost going to be, you know, game over every time. So hopefully we can play against something a little different in the next few rounds to get a little bit of diversity, but we'll see.